Guys, please check your audio and video settings, please. Guys, please check your audio and video settings, please. Guys, please check your audio and video settings, please. Yes, our today's topic is, first you see the application, you will get the idea. HTML to servlet communication example. Yesterday we played with welcome files. We are happy with that. We worked with welcome files in multiple angles, guys. We enjoyed that. If request URL is coming, generating request without any request path, then it looks for welcome file configuration, right? Okay, today I want to take form.html as what? I would like to take form.html as welcome file, guys. Okay, now let me open my form.html. By default, it is generating what mode request, guys? Get mode request. By default, it is generating what mode request. No mode is specified. Default mode is get. Or you can mention method is equal to get extra. Okay, get mode request. Super, guys. Now right click. Run on server. Say next, say finish. Say next, say finish. Raja 30, Delhi. Click on register. You are eligible for voting, guys. You are eligible for voting. Click on it. Jani 30, Delhi. Rani, Jani, you are eligible for voting. So now I changed this get mode request to post mode request. I changed this get mode request to post mode request. Right click, run on server, say next, say finish. Oh, no, that maybe that is not reflected, guys. Now I change it to post, guys. .405 error has come saying that HTTP method post is not supported by this URL. Did you notice it? Then what should I do? When I change this get to post, in my servlet component also, I have to change doGet method to doPost method. In my servlet component also, I have to change doGet method to doPost method. This is very complex to do or not. This is very complex process to do. If you want to get SOP message with method message, with method related message, then you have to write sys_trace. Then you have to write sys_trace. Got it? Yes, boss. Right click, run on server, save finish, save OK. Now back, reference. Person name 30 Delhi, click on register. See, now it is working. Now it is calling do post method. But whenever end user change get to post, post to get, come on, it's practically impossible to come and modify the source code, right? Come on. Practically impossible to modify the source code. Sometime two different requests may come. One have get mode request, one have post mode request. In one servlet only I want to write the logic. For example, bureau form page, I have one hyperlink. What is that? Get wish message. one hyperlink is there here, submit. Submit button is generating post mode request. Hyperlink is generating get mode request. Both requests are going to same servlet. Then also I should be in a position to differentiate the logic. So we have to consider all these things, guys. Come on. How to make our servlet component flexible to process both get comma post mode request. How to make our servlet component flexible to process both get comma post mode request. Are you listening my statement or not? Both get comma post mode request. Super. Both get comma post mode request. Okay. There are multiple approaches, guys. Approach number one. Bad approach. Why bad? I'll explain later. Okay. Keep request processing logic in the service method. Okay. Keep request processing logic in service method of servlet component class. Keep request processing logic in service method of servlet component class. Yes, boss. Now tell me here, what is this? Public class water servlet extends HTTP servlet. Here is my public void service. HTTP servlet request REQ. HTTP servlet response RES. Throws servlet exception, comma, IO exception. Yes, guys. Yeah, now, sir, already you said not to use service method. Yes, some advantages are there, some disadvantages are there. Advantages of working service method. It can process both get and post mode request. Yes, one service method can process both get and post mode request. Understanding my statement, that is the pros. Pros means advantages. Okay. Using one service method, we can process both get and post. Post mode method, one and the same, guys. Mode method request. Using one service method, we can process both get and post mode or method request, guys. Post mode or method request. Everyone understood my point there or not? Yes, guys. Right. Yes, here is my water servlet, boss. Here is my water servlet. Right click, run on server, say next, say finish. Say next, say finish. Okay. Now, I want to take service method. Now, first let me show the service method is processing both. Here is my service, guys. Okay. Here also I am taking service word, guys. Hyphen comma, hyphen. Nice. Hyphen comma, hyphen. Nice. Tell me. Run on server. Say next. Say finish. Okay. Say next, say finish. Raja 30 Delhi. Come on. Here is my register button. Mr. Miss Raja, you are eligible for voting. Okay. Service method. Right now it is processing post mode request. postmod request does not show anything in the browser address bar. Shura sir, yes, check it out. Post gives security, security. Right, now I'm changing to get mode, guys. I'm changing to get mode request. Form.html, here I'm changing to get mode request. I'm seriously changing to get mode request. Come on, guys. Right click, run on server, say next, say finish. This one, say refresh boss. See, there is no security. There is no security. But this time service is ready to handle this request also. Did you notice it, guys? It is ready to handle get mode request and post mode request. Yes, service is having this advantage, but disadvantage is also there. Okay. We cannot differentiate logic for get comma post mode request. Get comma post mode request. So I said, I have a hyperlink, I have a form in the same HTML file. Both are giving request to same servlet. For hyperlink, I want to execute separate logic. For form submission, I want to execute separate logic. Form is sending post mode request. Hyperlink is sending get mode request. Can we differentiate the logic, guys? We cannot differentiate logic for get comma post mode request. Come on, guys. Okay. Not designed to process. Okay. Yeah, automatically changes, boss. Not designed to process. Okay. Seven modes of request. That are coming from different clients. Seven modes of request that are coming from different types of clients. Different types of clients means browser. Okay. Next, FTP client. Yeah, these are there to maintain the website, guys. FTP client, cPanel client, all these are towards maintaining, hosting the website on the internet, managing that website, removing that website from internet. At that time, these are required. FTP client, cPanel client. cPanel means control panel client, all these things. So browser can give only get and post mode request, guys, but remaining clients can give remaining modes of request. What are those seven modes, sir? Seven modes or methods are. At least you understood we have seven duplex methods. Seven duplex methods are given to process seven modes of request coming from different types of clients. Seven modes or methods are get, post, you know this, but along I'll explain about remaining five a lot. First, today you just try to know what is what. At right time, I will discuss them. Delete, trace options, guys. Seven are there. If nothing is specified, default is seven. Okay. Note. Browser as a client browser can, as a client to web application, browser can send only get comma post mode request. Get comma post mode request. So that's why we are worried about what? Get and post. That's the reason to process those requests. We are worrying about do get and do post methods. Don't confuse. These are HTTP protocol methods. And okay, these are HTTP protocol methods. 7-2 triplex methods are given by Java people, guys. In servlet component to process 7 modes of request, we have 7 do triplex methods are there. Do triplex methods are Java methods. Okay, request methods are, request modes are HTTP protocol standards, guys. Okay. Not designed according to the standards of protocol HTTP. So it is not industry standard. It is not industry standard. Come on, guys. Two service methods are given in servlet API. Okay, if first service method is used, it is not industry standard. Sorry, guys. Okay. Fake sake, when I introduce web hosting, I will introduce FTP client, cPanel client. Then you can see remaining 5 modes of request. But as a browser, it can send get and post. You are not listening class, Mr. Faisal Sake. Sorry to say this on your face. Just know I cleared. Don't worry about remaining 5. Right now, worry about get and post, because right now we are dealing with the browser as a client. You are not listening, sorry to say, because this is third time I am repeating that statement. In future, I will show how to keep our website onto the internet. That is called web hosting. At that time, I will introduce other type of client. Then we will discuss remaining 5 modes of request. Got it? Right, as a browser, we can send only get and post mode request. That's a generally, we develop website by keeping end users in mind. End users means browser. They operate through browser. So browser can send how many modes of request? Get and post mode request. That's the reason we also deal in our servlet component only do get and do post methods. Fine, guys. Two service methods are given in servlet. If first service method is used, okay, we get servlet request, comma, servlet response objects. We get servlet request, comma, servlet response objects, which cannot be used to work with the protocol HTTP features, This is another problem that we are having. Okay, guys. Mr. Saman, please ask your problems related to practicals at the beginning or at the end, not in the middle of the subject discussions. Please show some common sense while attending classes. Okay, since you asked, I am answering. 500 error came up. Okay, check it out. Class name may be not taken public. Wrong class name is specified in web.xml. Wrong service method name. Somewhere typing mistakes might have happened. Check it out. Somewhere instantiation and visibility problem towards servlet class. Check it out that. Okay, guys. Pros, cons. I think you understood my point, guys. Okay. Okay. different types of clients, different types of clients can give different modes or methods of HTTP requests. Different types of clients can give different modes or methods of HTTP request. Okay. In servlet component to process different modes of HTTP request. Different modes of HTTP request, we can use different duplex methods. Okay guys, how many are there here? Seven duplex methods are there. Okay guys, tell me, to process get mode request we have doGet method. What do you say guys? To process post mode request we have doPost method. To process put mode request we have doPut method. To process delete mode request we are having doDelete method. To process trace mode request we have doTrace method. Come on guys, to process we have a doTrace method. Tell me guys, next one is what? To process head mode request we have doHead method. To process options modes request we have doOptions method. We simply got what guys? doOptions method. This is what we need to focus guys. Are you comfortable guys? Come on. So this is about this, but limitations are more guys. Okay, approach, that's why approach number one is bad approach. Shall we move to second approach? Okay, browser can give only get and post mode request. I know you are excited to see other modes of request, but you have to wait. So right now we are bothered about only these two modes of request guys, because as a browser we can get only get and post mode request. If you try to give other modes also, they will be treated as a get mode request. You want to see that? Okay, I'll make you to feel that. See here, method is equal to head I have taken. See this, that will be treated as get mode request only. How can you say that it will be treated as get mode request? Here wantedly I'll keep doGet method. Generally doGet can handle only get mode request now guys. So here also doGet. So as a browser, using browser, we can give only get and post mode request guys. If you give post, it will take. If you give other than get, it will be treated as a get only. Other than get and post, if you give anything, it will be treated as get only guys. Raja 30 Delhi, click on it. See what is doing? Doget only executing. But actually I have given what? I have given what head mode request. Suppose on demand, I will go for a trace mode request. What mode request, guys? Trace mode request. Yeah, server changes the changes dynamically. Refresh, view source. See, trace is coming in the browser. In the browser address bar, trace is coming. It's not like the trace is not coming. Definitely trace is coming, no doubt in that. Okay, yeah. January 1, 2020, Hyderabad. Click on it. See, still DoGet is executing. At least you can convince it, boss. Okay, guys. While working with browser, if you try to specify other than get comma post mode or method for request, that will be treated as get mode request. Sorry, if service method also present, then also it will be treated as get mode request. You take service method or do get method or anything, it will be treated as get mode request. Other than get and post, any mode you give while working with the browser, it will be treated as get mode request. I hope you enjoyed my point, guys. Come on. I hope you thoroughly understood my point, guys. Yes, this is approach number one, guys. Shall we go for approach number two, boss? Approach number two. Good approach. Recommended approach. Yeah, I'm having two versions in that. Version one. If get comma post mode request wants to execute same request processing logic. Version one is given. If get comma post mode request wants to execute same request processing logic. Understanding my statement, guys. Super. Okay, then what is the solution? The solution is very simple, guys. Override both doGet, doPost methods. Keep request processing logic in one method. And call that method from other method.
That's it. Keep request processing logic in one method and call that method from other method. Simply, you need to call that method from what? Other method. Simply, you need to keep that call that method from other method. Is that clear, guys? Come on. Comfortable with me, boss? Right. Okay. See, boss. Here is my doGet method. Here is my doPost method. Right. I'll give sample code because sample code is very easy to understand. Public class voter servlet extends HTTP servlet, guys. Okay. Public wide doGet throws servlet exception, comma, IO exception. Request, comma, respond. Here is my request processing logic, guys. Here is my request processing logic. Come on. Public void do post request comma response throws servlet exception comma IO exception that internally calls doGet comma do post end of voter servlet, guys. Now you observe. You give get mode request, it execute doGet method, executes the request processing logic. Cool. You give doPost method, it will come to doPost that internally calls doGet, control goes to this. How many times you have written request processing logic? One time, but it is responding for both get mode and post mode or not. This is a nice thought, na boss. For both modes, I want to execute same logic. For both modes, I want to execute same logic. Come on, guys. But I don't want to write same logic twice by taking doGet and do. Write in one method and call that method from another method. Very, very interesting solution or not. You give get mode request, directly doGet execute. You give post mode request, do post call the do post internally calling doGet. Easy na boss, come on, convince it with me boss. Right, let me implement. Yes, I have overridden doGet. There I have written request processing logic. Here is my doPost boss. Here is my doPost. Okay, see, slowly I'm adding the points. First I introduce doGet doPost. Now I'm asking betterment so that no burden on your brain also to learn at a time. Do request comma response, and we have a solid reason why service method is not good also. I discuss. Yes, at the end I will tell why do get do post methods are great also. I'll explain, don't worry. See, everything is implemented perfectly there. Here is my do get right now. My form page is going to give get mode request, guys. What mode request? Get mode request. Yes, changes will be taken dynamically, you know that. Okay. So Raja 30 Delhi. Nice. You observe the server console, guys. DoGet is executed. What is executed? DoGet. Say post. Post. Understanding my statement, guys. Post. Right, now you observe this one. Right click, refresh. Right click, refresh. Raja 30 Delhi. But I want to refresh once. Yes. Raja 30 Delhi. Click on it. This time what happened? First do post is called and do post is internally calling doGet. First do post is called and do post is internally calling doGet. Am I touching my servlet source code, guys? When I'm changing get to post, post to get, my servlet component has become flexible to work with both get and post mode request or not. Both get and post mode request or not. What do you say, guys? Come on. Enjoyed my point there or not? Thoroughly understood my point there or not there? So this is my recommended approach, guys. This is my recommended approach. Okay. Yeah, this is approach number two. This is approach number version two, guys. Version two. If get comma post mode requires wants to execute two different logics. Okay, if get comma post mode requires want to execute two different logics. If get comma post mode requires want to execute two different logics. What logics, guys? Two different logics. Yeah, same request and response objects are passed to same do. Wants to execute two different logic. Then what should I do? Okay, very simple theory, guys. In our servlet component, override doGet method and place get mode request processing logic. Get mode request processing logic. Similarly, override doPost method. And place post mode request processing logic. DoGet method, get mode request processing logic. DoPost method, post mode request processing logic. Yes, boss. Yes. Let me give the sample code, guys. Public class water servlet extends HTTP servlet. Come on. Public wide doGet. What is that, guys? Public wide doGet request comma response throws servlet exception comma IO exception. Here is what get mode request processing logic. Get mode request processing logic. Here is my doPost. Post mode request processing logic. Come on, guys. Here is my doGet get mode request processing logic. Here is my doPost post mode request processing logic. Is that clear, guys? Understanding my statement here or not there? Override doGet get mode request. Override doPost. Go for post mode request processing logic. Are you comfortable, guys? Come on. Sir, how you think about doing it? Very simple. Okay, form page I am taking post, guys. Okay. Now at the end I am adding one hyperlink also. BR. AHREF. Hyperlink always generates what mode request, guys? Get mode request. Hyperlink URL typed in the browser address bar generate get mode request. Form page can generate either get mode request or post mode request. Come on. AHREF water URL. Okay. Get sysdate. Some hyperlink, boss. Get sysdate, guys. Now tell me what I'm going to do. I'll make this one as a doPost method. DoPost method, because here anyhow form related request processing logic is there. I'll make this one as a doGet method, guys. Okay, here is my doGet method. Yeah. So here I will try to write the same code. What is that? Getting print writer, getting response, content type, all this stuff. So now I want to display date and time, guys. Okay. Write request processing logic. Date D is equal to new date of. Super. pw.println br h1 style. Color colon red. Text hyphen align center. Are you comfortable, guys? Come on. Control plus shift. java.util.date. H1 style. Color colon red. Text hyphen align center. Text hyphen what? Align center. After that, what next, guys? Text hyphen align center. Okay. System date and time. Colon colon plus D. Close H1. Okay, boss. Add hyperlink. You want to add graphical hyperlink or normal hyperlink? That's up to you. Then close stream. See, boss, doGet is taking care of hyperlink-based request processing. My doPost is taking care of what? Come on. Post mode based. That means form-based request processing logic. My theory and practicals are matching or not matching. In doGet, get mode request processing logic. In doPost, post mode request processing logic. Here I can write separate logic. Right click, run on server, say next, say finish. Yeah, for form also you can use doGet, but for hyperlink we cannot take post mode, na? That's why I'm taking form for post. For form can handle get and post mode request. Okay, using form we can go for get and post mode request, but using hyperlink post is not possible. That's why I have adjusted like this. Raja 20 this. Okay, form is working now. Click on hyperlink. Sys date and time. Now hyperlink is working. Sir, there is no provision, sir. Post means it has to carry data. Hyperlink cannot carry data. That's why no post for hyperlink. Use common sense, Ra Babu. Post is for posting data, sending data. Hyperlink cannot carry data. Come on. Why means what can I say? Basic designing is like that. Post means posting data, sending data. Hyperlinks cannot carry the data. That's why hyperlinks cannot send post mode request. I think everyone fully convinced with this or not. This is the best approach. Approach to is the best approach. Both version 1, version 2 are super solutions, guys. I'll give approach 3 also, but you will say approach 2 is good. Approach 2 is good. Right. Now let me say note. Form page can send get or post mode request. Whereas hyperlink and the URL typed in browser address bar can send only get mode request. Okay, get mode request. Okay, let it be. Now I would like to go for approach number 3. After seeing this, you only say, sir, approach number 3 is same as approach number 2. I don't want to waste my energy. I'll stick with approach number 2 only. Approach 3, guys. Okay. Extension of approach 2. Okay, you may consider to use extension of approach 2 and you may consider to use. That's it. Not so serious, guys. You may simply consider to use. That is approach number 3, guys. Approach 1, here approach 2, guys. Here is my approach 3. Shall we move now? Come on. Got it, boss? Here version 1 is same, boss. If get and post mode request wants to execute, same request processing logic. Then what is the answer? Answer is very simple. Okay, answer is all. No, this is just extension, yes. In servlet component, take user defined method having the same signature of service method. Okay, if possible second service method, having the same signature of second service method. Okay, and place request processing logic in that method. Not and, to place request processing logic. And call that method from both doGet and doPost. From both doGet and doPost methods. Call that method from both doGet and doPost methods. Are you understanding my statement here, guys? Come on. Are you understanding my statement here or not? Okay. Call that method from both doGet and doPost method. doGet and doPost method. Convinced with me, guys? Convinced with me, guys? Tell me, guys. Public class voter servlet extends HTTP servlet. Public class voter servlet extends HTTP servlet. Public wide process. This is user defined method. Any name you can take. HTTP servlet request req. Same signature, guys. Otherwise, it's impossible to call from doGet doPost methods. HTTP servlet response res throws servlet exception, comma, IO exception. Here is my request processing logic. signature means everything, boss. Method name also called signature. Return type also comes under signature. Signature means everything. You are supposed to learn that terminology in core Java. Yes or no? Na? You are asking what is signature in advanced Java? Na? Super, no problem. Better late than never. Okay. Signature, that means method name. See, that's why I have taken user defined method having same signature. So user defined method, I said, na, remaining all things should match. That's the meaning of it. Come on. Okay, since I mentioned user defined method, remaining all should match. Okay, guys, request processing logic. Now what? Do get method. Calling process request comma response. Do post method. Calling do post request comma response. End of the class. Are you understanding my statement or not? This is my process method. This is my doGet method. This is my doPost method. Here is my doGet. Here is my doPost. Yes, boss. See, I have given getMode request. It comes to doGet and it calls process method. Should I demonstrate this, guys? Should I demonstrate this? Not required. Same as approach to boss. Same as approach to one method is increased, right? Right. That's why I don't give damn importance to what approach three. My favorite is always approach two. My personal favorite is always approach. Instead of two method, going for three method and getting the same effect is really meaningless or not there. Come on, guys. Right. Version 2. Okay. Let's take version 2. When get and post mode wants to execute two different logics. Get and post mode logic wants to execute in two different logics. In servlet component. Okay. Place getMode request processing logic. GetMode request processing logic. Place GetMode request processing logic. Nikshala, will you place the code for approach to? I already demonstrated code of approach to. I don't know where, in which dunya you are, boss. I already demonstrated and I'm going to share this application also. Don't worry. Today onwards, I will keep applications in the Git and I will give that URL to you people. You can download entire application. In servlet component, place getMode request processing logic in user defined method one and call that method from doGet method. Similarly, place. Here two extra methods, another headache. Similarly, place post mode request processing logic in user defined method 2 and call that method from doPost method. Okay. Right. Subham, service method is not at all recommended to use, but all these duplex methods are internally called through service method. So we don't expose service method in real practices. In real practices, we always work with the duplex methods. Now let's see these guys. Okay, boss. Process get. I'm taking one method. Hey, method name is my choice, guys. Don't think much. Method name is my choice. Here, the method I'm taking is what? Process get. Okay. What is this? Get mode request processing logic. Get mode request processing logic, guys. Okay. Now tell me. Get mode request processing logic. Say paste. Here is my doGet method. Here I'm going to call process get method. What method, guys? Process get method. Process get request comma response. Process get request comma response. Cool, guys. Next. Save paste. Process post, guys. Here is my post mode request processing logic. Post mode request processing logic. Right. That I am going to call from what? Do post method. Do post method. Do post method. What is the method we want to call, guys? Yeah, don't worry about the spells, guys. Worry about the concept. Process process post request comma response. Come on, guys. I think you convinced it with me. To save time, I just used copy paste. Tell me, this is one user defined method. This is another user defined method. Two user defined method. Okay, this is called from doGet method. This is called from doPost method. Everyone understood my point here, guys. Come on. Everyone enjoyed my point here or not? Everyone enjoyed my point here or not? Everyone got it? I'm not demonstrating approach three, guys, because I want you people to work with approach two. Enjoyed thoroughly, boss? Right. Okay, now I want to present advantages of doXXX method, because industry standard is working with the doXXX methods. Okay, number one, gives HTTP servlet request, comma, HTTP servlet response objects to work with protocol HTTP features. Come on, guys. gives HTTP servlet request, comma HTTP servlet, any all features auto refresh every feature. Okay, next. By taking do get comma do post method definitions in one servlet component, we can differentiate logics for get comma post mode request. Seven doTriplex methods are given. Seven doTriplex methods are given. We can differentiate request processing logic. Tell me. Seven doTriplex methods, seven modes of request. Seven modes of request coming from different types of clients. Coming from different types of clients. Seriously, literally. Next. Okay. DoTriplex methods are designed according to HTTP standards. So these are industry standards. So these are industry standard. Everyone convinced, boss? Everyone convinced. Today onwards, we'll work with approach two. Approach two means full of doTriplex methods. Yeah, in future, I will introduce other types of clients. In web services also, we'll get different types of clients. Okay. In web services, we'll work with the different types of clients. In hosting, we'll work with the different types of clients. Okay, but as on today, you just worry about get and post mode request coming from browser. That's why you focus more and more doTriplex methods. So overall, more and more do get and do post method. As of now, industry standard is what, guys? Come on. As on today, industry standard is approach to. And I want you people to work with approach to daily. 1 minute, guys. I think I remembered them. GitHub.com. Oh, sign in. Six digits verification code. Natraz@gmail.com. Okay, no problem, guys. 462955. Yes, I am creating a new repository, guys. Okay. I will teach GitHub workshop later. Already tutorials are there. If interested, you can take it. Natraz World, I'm creating new repository. That means to keep all your projects, I'm creating new repository. What's your batch? I think already for your batch one is there, na boss. Already there. What is that? NTAJ414. NTAJ not there. NTAJ114 is not there, guys. Not there for your batch. 414 There na? There are not there? Yes. Oh, okay. I'm pasting that URL, guys. 114. This is the URL. Everyday content will come. Don't worry. All applications will come. Harshal, GitHub workshop is already uploaded in the YouTube. In my videos, you can search. Workshop also will be conducted later. But today, you just click on hyperlink. You will get some download at a zip file. In that one, all applications will be there. Every day, you have to download fresh zip file, guys. Yes, 1 minute. Switch off your mic, guys. Yes, now these two projects I'm keeping in the Git. Yes. Chaitanya ji, search in the internet one or other URL you will get for downloading, boss. Generally in my system, my hardware department people will install that. Team commit. Save okay. What is that? HTML to servlet communication. Say push. Say preview. Again push. Yes, this is the URL. I'm pasting anything with extension Git, without extension Git, anything is okay. Take it. Can someone verify whether it is came or not? Can someone verify whether it is came or not? Came na? It will reflect. In the repository, it will reflect. Already only JDBC is there. If you refresh, you will see two more projects. How to download, sir? Code section. Okay, download zip. You extract the zip, all the three projects will be there. Okay, don't worry, JDBC, you don't worry. You worry about these two applications. So now onwards, applications will be given like this. Enjoyed my point, guys? Come on.